Hello YouTube, Gundam here. Oh come on, stupid idiot. I'm here to show you a quick tutorial on how to do my map. You know, how you play it. Now, I'm in single player, so bear with me. The main thing people need to know is how you take over a new location. Now, first thing you need to know, my mob spawner changer goo unit is broken. So, there will be no mob spawn changes anytime soon. Which is really quite bad. You're wondering why? Well, think. I'd love to have a few hundred mob spawners throughout this map, at least. So you gotta go through each location and clean out the spawners in order to secure it. That can't happen. So, well, my map is pretty much broken. But I will hopefully be able to find a way, not too long from now, on how to fix that. Right now, if I were to click on a mob spawner, it would crash Minecraft, which is not good. Now, you're asking, well, what am I doing? Well, this is the simple way on how you would change out the... Well, if you've taken over an area. Now, because my mob spawner is broken... Come on. What that means is... I would now have to head out. And... Oh, I don't know. It has something to do with... manually put in each zombie. I'm probably just gonna put in a lot of dispensers and then have a bunch of pressure pads, you know, something like that. Now, what I am doing is showing you how you would take a location. If, say, you've cleared out all the zombies, okay, that's the first step. You clear out all the zombies and any spawners that are there. Next, you go into the spot. And you would place a wall. Pretty much the same design as what I'm doing here. I'm showing you for a corner. It's pretty simple. You just need a few buttons, a lot of wood. Oh yeah, don't forget torches. The first thing you should do, get in, put in the outer wall, the two high unit. So that way, no one can spawn. Then you have to close that and put it next to it. The reason is, you got your doors there and there instead. Oh yeah, that's still... Oh, I'll fix that later. See, it was there, but I moved it. So, some of this you're going to have to want to do at, you know, in the daytime. You know, but you can do the main wall, this two high unit, at night. You just put it, you see where I put it? You put it on the central line there, and you just take it to the middle points. I'll have to go in and fix all the holes in the... system later. Once you have... Oh yeah, but you would do the doors last, so this would still be closed up, and so would the other side. But after you have the main walls, and you've cleared out all the zombies, put down a bunch of torches, then put down this inner unit, as well as fences along the entire top like this. I know, it's a lot of fences, but this is how you will do it. Okay, this is how it should be done. It's time consuming, but that's kind of the point. Now this is a one slot unit, it's only taking up one city block, the graveyard here. So it's not that bad. You still have to do quite a bit of work, of course. Now you're wondering, why do the fence? Well, think. You can stand here and be pretty well protected while taking a look. Then you hop on top and you just shoot at them. You shoot all the zombies. After you've taken them out, after you've. Hey, die. After you have secured the area and put up torches and finished that wall, then you take down the separation wall. It'll take you a minute, of course, but you'll get your supplies back. You also get the doors that were up. So that'll help you save on materials because you have infinite wood because of all the trees, but you only have a certain amount of iron and stone to make more buttons. So you want to make sure to use your wood cautiously. That's a lot faster. Okay, that'll be sort of what it looks like if you take the graveyard first. The reason is, well, it's not quite because obviously there's torches missing. You need quite a few torches. Now I might have gone a little crazy, but that's the beginning fort. But yeah, when you're done, it'll look like that, except for there'll be torches. You need enough torches that no monsters can spawn. Because if they spawn inside of it, that's bad. Now, I'll be a helper to the people, of course. No, I'll be a standard player, and I don't think I'll be team leader. But also, every night I'm going to have to head out and put zombies. And when they say they want to take a location, I gotta put in zombies. So I'm probably just gonna stick around in creative mode. It's really just for the other players. I'm gonna pretty much be in creative mode just to help them out. So that means there has to be a sort of boss that stays online the whole time. Unless I can find out a way to get my monster spawners to work. If that'll happen, I'll put them all over the place and then I can actually enjoy my map. Fancy so that. By the way, this map, 95% of the brown is where we should have built. However, we couldn't build it because, well, people decided they'd rather do pixel art than actually build a map. Now, I will thank anyone and everyone who has assisted in any way, shape, or form, but I do wish you would have done a little more work. Now, that means areas like that will be pretty much left empty, although that one in particular I'm going to fix because if you jump off the crane right now, you'll die. I'm gonna probably just make this a big swimming pool. Let's say you wanted to take this library. You cannot go into the library and kill all the zombies. Well, you can, but you cannot extend the walls to all the way to the library unless you have already secured the school. You have to kill the zombies in the library and kill the zombies in the school. Then you have to extend the walls to the school, and only after the walls of the school are done, you have the whole set. You got the fence, you got the two high, you got the one high behind it, you have the doors and torches everywhere. Once that is complete, then You can do the library. But be careful if you don't do it quick enough, you know, then the zombies will come back in. So that'll be a problem. You'll be coming down. You know, you'll kill all the zombies in there and then immediately order builders to get building. But if you kill zombies in here at the same time, then if the builders are slow or if they run out of materials before they can finish, then zombies might retake this and you'll have to come back in and kill it. Now, when the server goes up, I'm gonna have to race around everywhere and put in a bunch of dispensers and eggs and things like that. Rule is, you are supposed to kill zombie spawners. Don't kill any other spawners. Like here, you've got some good spawners. They'll get you some animals, like there. Also, I need to put in some chests. I'll be doing that. I'll only put them in when you take the location. Just a few wind chests, because it's a scavenging trip. Like here, there's nothing really of value. But there, you've got some diamonds. That'll come handy. And a golden apple. Hey. So yeah, that's how that works. Now, if you want to, say, take this mini mart, you can't take that farm there and then go diagonal and take it. No. It has to be right angles. So you would either take the large farm, or take that one, then you would either take that or this, then you can take the mini mart. Now, as for taking double structures, or even triple structures, or quad structures, you know, things that take up more than one square, all you have to do is kill all the zombies in the whole thing, but you cannot begin the walls at all until you've killed all zombies and all spawners. So that'll be bad. Alright? So, yeah. Luckily, it'll be easy because once you take out all the enemy spawners, not to mention, of course, the ones that are there and that one, of course, you know, you would put the wall on the yellow line going to there, then on the orange line, and then you do the other ones. Once you have the two high wall, then you should be better off. You go in, put a bunch of torches down once you have the two high wall, and you have people building the other. So the warriors that would go out and kill stuff, you can put down some torches while you're killing stuff to help. You know, it'll help you kill stuff. But mainly the builders are supposed to do it. Now, builders can also be, you know, guards of the wall, but that's normally just during a zombie attack, and I'm gonna be busy for those. So it's gonna be hard, but I'll be here to explain it. Now, these are dance floors. Obviously, one of them's okay, the other two kind of blew up. And this, well, that should be obvious. Now, of course, it's not supposed to be bright in here. But glass, well, glass is glass. Let me, can I change it? Oh, sweet. Give me a. Wait a minute. I'm gonna try that in a minute first. Oops. Where's the zombie? Zombie, 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 zombie. Creeper skeleton. Where's the thing that's a zombie? Isn't it supposed to be green? There it is. It doesn't look like a zombie now. Oh. So it does go through glass. Yeah, you're fine. You're not. Oh, they're tricked because. Okay. Because of the glass. Well, he'll be fine. As long as he stays in there. So, okay, he might drown. Okay, so yeah, that'll work. The main thing you gotta do is research. Yeah, I want to finish the mall, so I'm gonna need some help with that. But, I'm gonna need some help with that. There's no way I can do it myself. Now, oh. There's only one lab.